Welcome to this video on Advanced Search Techniques in SharePoint 2013. This video describes how to use Boolean operators, properties, and other techniques in the SharePoint search box so you can quickly find exactly the information you need. There is a companion video on basic search techniques, and we suggest you view it first if you haven't done so yet. Boolean operators include AND, OR, and NOT. They are a way to create a more precise search query from within the search box. The OR operator returns results that contain any of the search terms. For example, e-signatures or training is a very broad search because it returns all results that contain either term. Here, our results number about 17,000. The AND operator returns results that contain all of the search terms. So, e-signatures and training is a narrower search because it returns only those results that contain both terms. We see about 156 results. The NOT operator excludes terms from the search. If we search for e-signatures, we see 289 results. But if we search for e-signatures not training, we see 133 results. We've reduced the number of results because the content must not include the term training. You may be wondering what happens when you enter words without an operator. If we search for e-signatures training, we'll see about 156 results. Now, let's search for e-signatures and training. Since the number of results is the same, you can tell that search queries use the AND operator by default. You can also use special characters and item or file properties in your search queries. Quotation marks indicate that you want to match the exact phrase. For example, the search for e-signatures training has only two results because they must contain both words in that specific order. If you are unsure of spelling or if you want word patterns, you can use an asterisk as a wildcard. For example, a search for e-sign returns results that include the words e-signature, e-signatures, or e-signed. If you know who created a file, you can search by the author property. You can search for a specific file name. You can search by exact title. And you can find particular types of files, such as PowerPoint presentations, by searching for the file extension. You can combine these techniques to create very powerful searches. Here are a few examples. You can use wildcards in a property search. Here, search results will include all file names that start with e-notary. You can combine Boolean and property searches like this. We see two results for PowerPoints that have the .ppt extension and that contain both terms. Here's the same search, except it uses the newer PowerPoint extension of .pptx. This time, we get about 28 results. Rather than conduct separate searches for .ppt and .pptx files, you can use a wildcard along with Boolean and property searches like this. As expected, we get about 30 results. Here are a few more examples of additional properties you can use in search. Size, path, last modified time, and modified by. If you have viewed our video on basic search techniques, You'll realize that file type, author, and modified by are similar to the refiners in the left column. In this video, we've demonstrated the use of Boolean operators, quotation marks, wildcards, and properties in SharePoint 2013 search. These techniques work the same way on both inside NCDOT and connect NCDOT. If you don't want to remember and use this special search terminology, there's another video on the advanced search page where you have an easy-to-use visual interface. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there's a link to help on every page. Go to the main Help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the Help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.